Friends, when I said self-discovery is a continuous process, when I said self-awareness is most important, a simple question: how much importance you give to yourself? Yes, you give importance to your teacher, you respect your parents, you respect your elders, you are all the time at their service or at the helm of affairs. But how many times you get into involvement of self-understanding? If you are unable to get this, please do it. If you want, how are you behaving? How are you today competent or confident? If you are unable to understand, get the help of your colleagues, friends, relatives, co-workers. Just ask them, what I am good at in your opinion? Maybe. Sometimes they will tell you that you can do this well, you are good at the cooking, you are good at oratory, you are good at craft, and many a times you don't know that I am really good at these things. So, if you share, if you ask others what is good in you, what you can do better, what you can do well, you may get valuable inputs. And then, can you just focus on them? Just try. I did it. I used to ask people in one of the training sessions. I just thought, to disrupt my monotonous talk, can I sing one or two lines of Bollywood Hindi music? And I just tried, and to my surprise, there were so many clappings. I said, if it is a respect to a trainer, I accept it. But one or two people came to me and they said, your voice is okay. You have a rhythm. You have the understanding of a sound, intonations and everything. So, why don't you try? Of course, frankly speaking, I have not yet started singing. But the fact is that when I took such feedback, the result was positive. I mean, I can sing. I have that sense of classical or semi-classical music or the rhythm. So, get the help from others. Friends, just few questions, they are on my slide. What did you notice about yourself this week? What am I noticing about myself today? Why your hobbies, likes, dislikes, or your emotions and experiences are like that? Why do I love a particular game? Why do I dress this way? Why don't I cry very often? Do you know yourself well? Do you have a sense of purpose? What makes you happy? Are you clear about your wants in life? What defines you? Friends, these are the many questions I have just asked you. Don't worry. You don't have to answer them immediately. Suppose, to some of these questions, if you find yourself, the answer for you is no, or answer from your side is, don't really know, no problem, because you never tried to understand self in terms of the awareness. What happens normally in our life, friends, that I am happy and contented with what I am today. I am professor of textiles. I am happy with my job. It's a government job. I get good salary. So, I am happy. I call these as current elements of my life, happiness. But others, you may not like. You will say that he has still something better. He has something else, which I don't have. And this dissatisfaction may be an indication that you have got things about your life that are unresolved. Means you want some satisfaction and really not happy with what you are today. And that's why most of the questions I just raised through these two slides earlier, probably some of them you had answer of no or don't really know. Friends, you may not know yourself. Yes, I agree. Just for the sake of a joke, I look at the mirror and I see everything is okay at its proper place. The shirt is okay. The coat is okay. No, I'm not talking about knowing such self. I am talking about something beyond. Many a times it happens that I am 30, I am 40, I am 50 years old, but still I do not know myself. The fact is that we all are busy. You get up early in the morning, just do fast your household activities, go to a job, engrossed in the work activity with the team, come back home, relax for a few minutes, look at the TV programs, read a book, and just go to sleep. So the busy schedules, you can say that you have no time to understand self, to look at the self. So such long hours we are working and mind is too much occupied in most of the things. Sir, how do I understand myself and where is the time? Not knowing yourself well is not a good sign. If you do not have clear idea about yourself, I mean who you are, what you like, where to go from here, these are the questions you have to ask yourself. Try to get the answers. Many a times, friends, when I ask questions to myself, who am I? What I am for? Why is my existence as this? Then I understand when I try to get answers to these questions that I have a lack of self-awareness. And if you do not understand yourself, it is likely to impact not only your emotional you, but maybe mental or spiritual you. Yes, I repeat, emotional, mental and spiritual you. I still remember we were in schools and we were taught by my teachers values in life, goals and its importance in life, beliefs. Am I clear about all those values in life which I have set? Am I clear about my beliefs or am I clear about my goals? Frankly speaking, in most of the situations, the individuals will adopt goals and values and beliefs which their friends or colleagues or parents are following and as if they are my own. I hope you understand. You have never asked yourself, what are my core values? What are my beliefs? What are my goals? And because of this, if I have adopted from some other person or persons, probably I did not have my own values or beliefs. And hence, I have no clear idea what are my personal boundaries. No, I am not talking about the body language or the zones like physical zones and all. I am talking about personality development and in that sense the boundaries. You may say that others are counting on you and your support. Are you counting on yours for yourself? Probably no. Your desires, your intents, keep changing day to day. Do you agree? I agree. Desires and intents change. So what? But still, understanding self is important.